We return now to the drama that unfolded in the St. Louis suburb of Ferguson, Missouri last night and dominated conversation across the country today. It was a scene of utter chaos that riveted the nation's attention. Stun grenades and tear gas exploded in the streets of Ferguson as heavily armed police aimed weapons from armored trucks. Police said they used force when a protest that began peacefully turned violent, with people throwing rocks and firebombs.
You must disperse immediately. This is no longer a peaceful protest when you try to injure people. You must disperse now.
With that, officers loosed the barrage of grenades and gas, sending the crowd fleeing.
We just said, hands up, don't shoot.
Is that all you were saying?
That's all we were saying. Hands up, don't shoot.
Were you in the front line up there?
In the front line, yes. And they just started shooting.
Both city and county officers were involved, and today they defended their actions. Thomas Jackson is chief of the Ferguson police.
There is gunfire. There are firebombs being thrown at the police. And I understand that what it looks like is not good. The whole situation is not good. We would like the protesters to stop the violence. We certainly don't want to have any violence on our part. You know, we want this to be peaceful. If individuals are in a crowd that's attacking the police, they need to get out of that crowd. We can't individually go in and say, excuse me, sir, are you peacefully protesting? Are you throwing rocks? Are you throwing a Molotov cocktail? It's a crowd.
The St. Louis Post-Dispatch reported 10 people were arrested. Among them, St. Louis City Alderman Antonio French, who had been chronicling events on social media, including several Vine video posts.
What do we want? Justice!
French was released this morning.
Stop videotaping. Let's grab our stuff and go.
Washington Post reporter Wesley Lowry recorded this exchange with police as he and a Huffington Post reporter were ordered to clear out of a nearby McDonald's.
We don't have time to ask questions. Let's go.
The reporters were detained and later released without any charges. Separately, members of an Al Jazeera America TV crew had to run for it after police fired tear gas as they prepared for a live report. Today, the police chief denied the media had been deliberately targeted. But the stark images from last night reverberated far beyond Ferguson. President Obama interrupted his vacation on Martha's Vineyard.
There is never an excuse for violence against police or for those who would use this tragedy as a cover for vandalism or looting. There's also no excuse for police to use excessive force against peaceful protests or to throw protesters in jail for lawfully exercising their First Amendment rights. And here in the United States of America, police should not be bullying or arresting journalists who are just trying to do their jobs and report to the American people on what they see on the ground.
Meanwhile, Missouri political leaders spent the day in Ferguson. U.S. Senator Claire McCaskill speaking after a community gathering sharply criticized police tactics.
I think that the police response needs to be demilitarized. Mm-hmm. I think that the police response has become part of the problem as opposed to being part of the solution.
Police Chief Jackson rejected the criticism.
The whole picture is being painted a little bit sideways from what's really happening, and it's not military, it's tactical operations, it's SWAT teams. That's who's out there, police. We're doing this in blue.
In a statement, U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder also voiced concerns about police actions and said the Justice Department has offered to provide technical assistance with crowd control. The night's events in Ferguson have swept across the web in a torrent of videos, tweets, and retweets. The chant of "hands up, don't shoot" had already morphed into a rallying cry on social media. This morning, Howard University in Washington, D.C. posted a photo on its Facebook page showing scores of students with hands raised and the hashtag "hands up, don't shoot." Similar photos from across the country also circulated online.
Don't shoot!
Hands up!
At the same time, the investigation continued into the incident that started all this, Saturday's shooting of 18-year-old Michael Brown. The identity of the officer who fired the fatal shot remained a point of contention. Authorities again said they are not ready to release the name, due partly to death threats. At one point, a Twitter account associated with the activist group Anonymous did publish a name that it said was the officer in question. That was flatly denied by police, and Twitter later suspended the account.